Good day. My name is Hans van Gorp, and I will be presenting the work on image denoising with deep unfolding and normalizing flows. This work was performed by Shinji Wei in collaboration with me, Lizeth Gonzalez, Daniel Friedman, Jonina Eldar, and Ruud van Sloen. So, image denoising with deep unfolding and normalizing flows is quite a mouthful, so let's delve into the details. Specifically, we are looking at inverse problems. So inverse problems are all around us. Think about black and white image coloration or denoising or medical applications such as MRI or CT or JPEG decompression. And central to inverse problems is the equation y equals ax plus n, where y is a measurement we have access to, x is some ground truth which we are trying to recover, but this problem is made difficult because either our matrix A is not an identity, or there is some additive noise n, or even both. So a popular way to solve inverse problems are with iterative algorithms, for example ISTA, iterative shrinkage and thresholding. And the idea behind this is that we have many iterations where we are doing two steps, namely data consistency, where we are trying to make sure that our recovered signal here, x hat, is close to our measurement y. And also we have some proximal operator, basically a prior on the structure of x. This could, for example, be a sparsity prior in, for example, Fourier domain. Now, the problem with these iterative algorithms is that we have to handcraft this prior and that it can take many iterations to actually get a good result. So, recently, a popular way to deal with this is by going with for deep algorithm unfolding. Here we unfold an iterative algorithm in way fewer steps, maybe three or five steps, and each fold of the algorithm, we will make sure to replace some parts with deep learning or neural networks. So specifically, this could look something like this, where we have a measurement y of, for example, an image of a celebrity, but we are missing part of this image, and we want to reconstruct, recover this full image here on the right. And over here we are showing the neural proximal gradient descent algorithm, where we have data consistency steps and learned proximal steps. Popular choices for this learned proximal step could, for example, be a UNet or a ResNet. However, these discriminative neural networks, we don't really know what's going on there under the hood. So we have chosen to explore whether you can also use normalizing flows for this learned proximal step. So let's take a bit of a detour here to think about, okay, what are these normalizing flows? So a normalizing flow is a type of neural network which is bijective. So we can go forward as well as backwards in this network. And the idea is that we have some complex distribution here on the right, and this could be any type of distribution. Over here we have these two semicircles, but it could also be the distribution of images. And on the left, we have a Gaussian space. And the idea here of the normalizing flow is to fit this algorithm in such a way that it will transform this complex distribution to a Gaussian distribution and back again, so it can go both ways. So coming back to our neural proximal gradient descent algorithm, the data consistency step we have not touched, but the learned proximal step we are now going to change with normalizing flows. So an image comes in on the left, an idea of an image, so in this case x tilde here, and we will map x tilde to this Gaussian latent space using our flow, the forward flow. So we will map to some place in this Gaussian space here, z. And then we know that the more likely solutions, so better images, are actually more close to the origin. So what we do is we perform a shrinkage step. Over here, 1, we multiply by 1 over 1 plus lambda, where this lambda is also learned and positive, so bigger than 0. So what we do is we move actually closer to the origin. And then Now, because our flow is bijective, we can do the reverse direction and map back to a better image here, X. So really what we're doing is we're taking this image X, going to Gaussian space, going to a more likely position in Gaussian space, and mapping back to a better image. So what does this look like over several folds? Well, over here we have the same example. We're missing this central square here of this image. And what we do is we start with an initial guess. Basically, z is zero at our flow, so the origin of the flow. We get this very interesting eigenphase here going on. And what we then do is we do a data consistency step. So we basically mix this image with this eigenphase, and then we get this going on. And then we do a step of flow, so we come closer to a more likely solution. But as you can see, the surrounding parts of the image, which we have actually measured, so we actually know what's going on there, we have reconstructed something different. So we do a data consistency step to make sure that it gets back to what it's supposed to be, right? So now we see that this outside is back to being normal again. And then we do again a proximal operator with a step of flow, data consistency, and again a step of flow. And as you can see, we then get a very nice recovered image here on the top, which looks almost similar to our target image X. So we are not restricted to inpainting. We can, of course, also do denoising, what our paper for ICASSP is actually showing, right? So we have here a denoising, and what we can see, we have compared our proposed flow proximal operator with a UNet and also a ResNet. And on top here, we've got a noise level of sigma 0.2, and then we can see that all of these networks are indeed able to denoise this image. Our proposed model does get the best results in terms of PSNR. And then here on this bottom row, we actually increase the noise level slightly. So important to know here, it's only trained on this 0.2 level, and we increase the noise only slightly to 0.25. And then we can see that our model still performs well, while these other models, these discriminative neural networks, they actually completely fail. So we see that these get some very strange reconstructions. So our model, this flow model, is a much more robust to changes in the measurement setup after training. So what have we seen? We have seen that normalizing flows are actually a more powerful proximal operator than standard discriminative neural networks, and that these normalizing flows allow for an explicit structural prior due to their Gaussian latent space. So I hope you found this interesting. You can, of course, visit us at the online poster presentation and hopefully also at the offline physical location in Singapore. Thank you very much.